Welcome to day two of my painting demo. As you can see, the paint dries a little bit darker than when it's put on. So I always have to do a reassessment of where I'm at after it's been allowed to dry for a good 24 hours. So I think I'm going to lighten up the background sky part first, then go back into the foreground today. So we'll just see how we do. So I've got a really pale turquoise color. See, sometimes it's not exactly what I want, and I might change my mind. But see how we go. Listen to the airplanes go by outside. Maybe we should put some music on. Would you like to hear some music? Let's see. Okay, so that's not going to work. I was hoping CBC had some good music, but they're talking right now, so we'll do that from there. Maybe. Do you like Leonard Cohen? Great Canadian songwriter and performer. Let's put on one, please. How's that for sound? That's not too loud? Do you know Leonard Cohen's music? A little bit. Yeah, my age is showing. So often, there's really no explanation for why I choose certain colors and layer them. It's just a feeling I want to try. Little threads of this kind of coral. Just add a little bit of warmth. Thank you. do some what I call ghost trees in the background, just kind of going up before I do the ones in the foreground. So I've always thought the perfect man for me would be one who could play the guitar and play that song and sing it to me. Leonard Cohen's I'm Your Man. Very, very sexy, romantic song.
Do you think the music you listen to affects what you're painting?
It does sometimes. Yeah, so sometimes I have classical music on, just instrumental. I've got a CD of the top best operatic songs that I attempt to sing to that nobody needs to hear. And then there's Neil Young and Leonard Cohen, and then to Amy Winehouse and Adele and others. Some movie soundtracks, some are really good.
I don't know if you've ever heard the movie soundtrack for Pulp Fiction. It's a great soundtrack. Well, any Tarantino film has a great soundtrack, but yeah, I mean, that's an especially good one. But anyway, so yeah, so sometimes I'm kind of in the mood.
And today, I like Leonard Cohen. I'm just thinking of think about Canadian performers. Heard on the news that I don't know if you know Norm Macdonald, the comedian. I think he's Canadian.
I do know him. Yeah.
I think he passed away yesterday. Something like, he was younger than me, 62 or something.
He's a really good comedian.
He's so funny. So funny. Natural Born Killers?
I have not.
Oh. It's quite the movie. It has Leonard Cohen's music thread. Alright, Adamson, what do you want to do? Okay, gotta do more of the foreground before I put the big trees in. So, I guess I've got trees. So some of these lines that I'm putting down are so thin that you don't really see them unless you look up close. But it just gives this kind of overfilm of
a shade that enhances what's underneath it and what's going to come on top. But anyway, it's hard to explain, but it's by putting these fine lines down,
it's like a little dusting of the color. Okay. Started with kind of browns and russets and
ochres, like the earth beneath the greenery, And then now I'm starting to build up. So I'm starting with blue greens, teals, and blue greens underneath the grass, and then I'll do other shades of green, and then probably end up with some yellows and ochres and thing at the top. At the end, I'll do that. Right now, just doing.
So I've got the blue greens, and then I'm going to do forest green.
Catherine, yep. How often do you paint a week?
Oh, sometimes zero, and then sometimes every day. So it just depends on what I'm working on. Sometimes I'll take a break. I'm also writing a book, and I'm working on that. But yeah, sometimes I'll get a lot of small canvases and then just do
a series of smaller ones, and then but I prefer working on the bigger ones like this one. So, yeah. So, usually every week I'm down here working on something. And then sometimes I'll let it dry for a couple of days just to kind of get my head out of it, and then come back with fresh eyes and see what it is and then build into it. So quite often I'll do that. I'll go 48 hours just because I need to get away from it. And then sometimes I'll turn it this way, then go up to the loft up here and then look down, and that gives me a whole new perspective on it. It gives some distance, so it's a good way to look at it. I don't have a set methodology, so it's kind of hard to
explain sometimes why I do any particular thing.
So. You say you're more instinctual or?
Yeah, definitely more instinctual. Like I never do sketches or draw any plan on the canvas before I start. I know for commission work, and people specifically want something. Like for example, a friend wanted
white hydrangeas. She wanted a good sized painting of white hydrangeas, so for her living room. And she wasn't sure on the size, if she wanted a square or rectangle, but you know, around 36 inches. So I ended up getting
three different canvas sizes, 30, 36 inch, 48, a little bit, some rectangle, some square. And I painted three different paintings of white hydrangeas. And then she could choose which one that she wanted. She ended up getting the square one,
which is fine. And then I've got the, I did one with brush on canvas, and then the other two were this style. So she chose one from this style that she liked the best. But
is that what you usually do for commissions?
Yes, I usually paint two or three, slightly various sizes and layouts. So I don't want to restrict myself to one set little kind of plan. I want to be able to just, each time I paint, I like to experiment and try different things.
So I'm not very good at taking orders and restrictions, but if I
do three of them, I know that the other two will sell eventually, that's fine. And then I'll choose one. I know I did, there was a husband-to-be who wanted an arbutus tree for painting for his wife for a wedding gift. And so I put,
so I did three different canvases, and I put their initials like a carving in the tree. So he was just thrilled that I did that. And then so they bought the one, and then they had the other two that of course still had their initials in it, which was kind of funny. And then the other day at Horseshoe Bay at the Blinn's Coffee Shop, I have a lot of paintings there. And I saw, oh, there's that painting with their initials in. So there's one left. That was kind of funny. Be funny if they came by Horseshoe Bay and actually saw their initials carved into the tree. Anyway, but yeah, that's the best way to do a commission is to give myself the freedom to experiment, and then they can choose. And I've had no complaints. People really like being able to choose and
see which one speaks to them.
Do you have any stories about a very good commission or a very bad commission?
Very good commissions. I don't have any bad commissions. I've had nobody want to return anything, ever. So thank goodness, I should knock wood. Anyway, there was there's a fellow and his wife on the island. Where they live?
Something like. Anyway, they already had a few of my paintings, and then the husband wanted another one. And I had been painting, this is at my other studio, but I had been painting this large painting of a field of wildflowers. And for some reason, I just had this urge to paint a bunch of daisies in it, which I don't normally do. Like at that time, I hadn't really painted daisies, these white flowers with the yellow centers. So, but for some reason, I had this urge to do that. And as soon as I finished, I washed up, went in the house, the phone rang, and it was this past client of mine who said he was looking for this type of a paint. Oh, he saw one on my website that he wanted. But his wife had a new yoga studio, and she wanted a painting that had daisies in it. Do I have anything with daisies? I don't see anything on your website. And I said, oh, I've got this soaking wet painting I just finished that I put all these daisies on. So I went out and took a picture with my phone and then sent it to them. And they were just thrilled. So then they chose, I think they chose a third one. So I ended up driving. I gave myself like a little holiday, take the ferry over to the island and travel up and deliver the paintings to them and visit other people I know on the island. But that was a very nice commission that I made good money on, and it just, you know, on a whim I painted daisies, and then I get this phone call, hey, you got anything with daisies? So it was just
it just worked out, right?
It was just the sweetest thing. It was really great. Anyway, so I quite liked it. Happy surprises from people. Darn it. I dropped a little bit of teal paint in my juice.
A little extra flavor?
Yeah, I don't think I'm going to drink it. I don't think that's going to do me any good whatsoever.
I agree.
Oh well. Time for that later. Sometimes I even confuse myself and ask, where are you going with this? To figure this out. I think what I want to do here. I think maybe we should stop for a minute. Just stop filming for a minute. Because when I do my big long trees, I need access. So I think what I should do is move this table over so that I have access here. Oh, hi, we're back again. So I'm going to start doing the outlines of the large trees that are going to come in here. Let's see. I need this first one to go. Thank you. find where I want these trees.
Just like this, the sun, the wind.
I'm thinking I want to give it a rest now, just rest, because there's other colors, trees that I want to put in, but I want to put in more ropes of color in with the orange and the burgundy tree, and then tomorrow I'm going to do like a bright turquoise and maybe a gold color. Let's see. Just try. So I think I should leave it like this, pretty thick paint. I don't want to put other colors on top of that because then it all bleeds. So I like it to stay. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Yeah. I think this, and then I'll come down over the day and look at it and then kind of envision what else I want to put in here. But I still have another day or two of really working on it, if that's okay. Yeah. I guess that's the thing with a big canvas too, is you've got more room to work around. So, yeah. Yeah, I'm liking where it's going so far. It's different. The orange trees, I wasn't planning. They just popped on. Then also raised the horizon line. So as I was going along, so it ended up being a little higher than I thought, but it's okay. It's still good. So I'm happy with it so far. So I think that's all we should do for today. And then I think tomorrow then I'll have a better idea of exactly where, like I wanna do a really big tree here. It's gonna overlap those, so I need to finish those before I overlap them. You know what I mean? So then they're definite background. I'm not going back into them and get paint on the foreground tree. So yeah, okay, thank you. See you next time.